fried eggs.
A golden with this close to breaking the record today. We were like as close as you can be without actually breaking the record.
That's right. And to have temperatures as warm as we experienced today at the end of December is, as you just mentioned, it is record warmth. Not record breaking, but record warmth. And we still continue to see warmer than average temperatures for the next few days, which means we may rank in the top five warmest Decembers of all time. But let's talk about today's daily temperatures. We climbed well into the 60s earlier this afternoon. In fact, we reached a high of 66 degrees, and that tied the previous record set in 2015 and in 2018. If we were one more degree warmer, we would have surpassed that. Temperatures now still warmer than normal. We're sitting in the mid-40s in the Dayton area when, on average, we should be hitting highs at about 39 degrees. We haven't even cooled down that far quite yet. We have 41 for you out in Wapakoneta, 43 in Bell Fountain. We're still sitting at about 48 degrees, nearly 50 down in Wilmington. Over the next 3 days, temperatures will come down slightly tomorrow, and that 47 degree high for tomorrow will actually come in close to midnight tonight, and then we're going to cool and stay in the low to mid 40s for the rest of the day Tuesday. But then Wednesday, we're going to bounce back into the 50s, and we'll reach a high of 50 again on Thursday. Then we get more rain by the end of the week into the upcoming weekend, right on time for New Year's Day, and that will be followed by that cool down heading into the new year. All right, right now outside, it is pretty quiet in the Miami Valley, other than a breeze that we still have. You can see blowing on our flagpole there in Troy. We have dry conditions overhead and cloudy skies still holding strong. As far as our wind speeds, we will watch them subsiding through the night. So tomorrow morning, we will not feel them as impactful as they are right now. But as we move through the day Tuesday, watch what happens. There's lunchtime. We start to see winds cranking right back up, a wind gust of 25 to maybe even 30 miles per hour. Those winds may enhance even further as the time we get home from work tomorrow. And you'll notice some of those gusts up over 30 at 6:30 there on Futurecast before they begin to subside once again tomorrow night. Satellite radar imagery right now is dry. We have a few breaks in the clouds overhead. I did notice some clearing when I was out on my dinner break earlier on. But now those clouds are coming back in as our next chance of rain is evolving. And you can see in the last few frames there in southern and central Missouri, rain becoming a bit more widespread. That will be pushing to the north, and we will track that into and through your Tuesday. So here's hour by hour Tuesday. We wake up in the morning near 6:30 a.m. May start to see some showers in the southern Miami Valley. By lunchtime, we have scattered showers throughout the entire viewing area. Futurecast does depict some blue there far north. That will likely be some snow showers mixing with rain showers, but everyone will transition over to a steady widespread rain as temperatures will be in the 40s through the day. We also have some enhanced rain there at times. Some rumbles of thunder, in fact, will enhance that rain, and that's really going to help those rain totals to stack up. By late evening into Tuesday night, we begin to dry out, and that dry weather is brief because on Wednesday, more rain comes back in. We start out Wednesday morning dry. Most of the day will be dry. As we get closer to dinner time in the evening, you can see that rain does return by Wednesday night. So rain totals for the next 48 hours, we're talking more than an inch everywhere, and that's going to give us a good soaking with some spots that may see upwards of an inch and a half. That will have an impact on your travel, especially tomorrow with rain through much of the day. Wednesday, especially late evening, we're dry Thursday, Friday, and then Saturday for New Year's Day, that's when we see more rain. So here's Futurecast for New Year's Eve. We are dry, so if you have plans for New Year's Eve night, we should be there with cloudy skies. Rain comes through on New Year's Day, and then as we head into Sunday, there might be a couple of flurries or a snow shower still around. Now, talking about rainfall and New Year's Day specifically, we've only seen 8 years with New Year's Day with a half an inch or more of rainfall. If we see that again this year, then we'll have 9 years. The record wettest for New Year's Day was 1.65 inches set in 1948. It's very possible we may come close to that this year. So we'll see if we hit a record or surpass it this weekend. So there's that 7 day, a wet day tomorrow, rain returns later Wednesday, dry for a couple of days, and then we start the new year wet, and then colder to follow. Molly, thanks, McCall.
Search and rescue crews confirm nobody